At Allstate Roadside, we're committed to bringing relevant and accurate information to help you on the roads. In this video, we're going to review methods for servicing and towing electric vehicles safely and professionally. We'll look at basic vehicle components, safety processes, and equipment used in roadside assistance and towing. There are two systems with an electric vehicle, the high voltage and the low voltage system. Let's start with the high voltage system. The largest component of the high voltage system is a large battery pack that typically resides beneath the passenger cabin between the wheels. These battery packs come in a variety of shapes and sizes based on the make and model of the vehicle. The high voltage battery is where energy that is used for propulsion is stored. This battery is charged by an external power supply. High voltage cables are identified by their orange color. Due to the added weight and the structural design of the high voltage battery cage, it is imperative that operators use manufacturer-approved jack points or tow cable attachment points. Improper attachment can result in significant damage. Refer to the vehicle's owner's manual if you're uncertain of approved jack or attachment points. The low voltage system works very similar to the 12-volt system in an internal combustion vehicle, including running the lights, power accessories, safety systems, and the infotainment screen. So while the low voltage battery itself doesn't drive the car, it keeps all the essential systems running smoothly, and without it, the vehicle won't move. If the low voltage battery is depleted, as indicated by no interior lights and a dark infotainment screen, you might need to provide external power to the low voltage battery boost points so that you can unlock the doors or place the vehicle in tow mode. Some electric vehicles have a keyblade that can be used in emergencies, or you can try accessing the front trunk using a release mechanism to release the low voltage battery boost point. With the ability to unlock EVs remotely, lockout service is rare, but standard lockout tools can be used. Most electric vehicle maintenance areas are protected with panels. Use caution when removing and replacing them. NHTSA and other agencies recommend that you do not store a severely damaged vehicle with a lithium-ion battery inside a structure or within 50 feet of any structure, vehicle, or combustibles. For all service work, wear ANSI high-visibility clothing in the appropriate class for the roadway in which you're working. Class 3 is for traffic in excess of 45 miles per hour and should generally be worn by service operators. Appropriate boots, gloves, and safety glasses protect your body's valuable tools. There is equipment that can be helpful for transporting and loading electric vehicles. A lead acid or lithium ion boost pack, tire skates, and non-conductive equipment, and a familiarity with how to use a tow pin and snatch block. There are circumstances when an electric vehicle will need to be skated onto your rollback. EVs are significantly heavier than their internal combustion counterparts and are often outfitted with wider tires. Operators that successfully tow EVs are proficient with skating and have the right skate for every job. Some of the non-conductive equipment that you might keep on your truck are straps in place of chains, luxury V-bridles, and lead straps. Avoid using J-hooks in almost every situation. Electric vehicle manufacturers recommend flatbed only, though some makes and models allow for wheel lift and dollies. Regardless of your method, you should never tow an electric vehicle with the drive wheels on the ground. 8-point tie-downs are universally recognized as the approved attachment method for these vehicles. You may encounter an electric vehicle with a charge nozzle stuck in the charge receiver. Most EVs have a manual charge nozzle release cable. As a rule of thumb, if the charge nozzle receiver is towards the front of the vehicle, look in the front compartment or the frunk for the release. If the charge nozzle is in the rear of the vehicle, check in the rear wheel well for the release cable. As always, refer to the owner's manual for the exact location. Tow mode or transport mode protect the electric motor and drivetrain, prevent excessive energy production, and maintain battery health, allowing you to load and transport the vehicle safely.
As always, refer to the owner's manual for the exact location.
This information is meant to promote industry best practices by towing and roadside professionals. This information is not intended to serve as a substitute for a company's own training, experience, or judgment. It is your job to evaluate the accuracy of any information presented here. Thanks, and be safe out there.